Defen prepares for the unforgiving 3-hour journey home. Her future looks uncertain. Another fall could kill her, and some predict she's still growing.
Her tumor is growing very slowly. She needs a replacement therapy of basic hormones for a long time.
Hormone replacement therapy is expensive, and Defen's family has already spent most of their savings on her recent hospitalization. Back in the UK, Professor Ashley Grossman has news of her blood tests. The results aren't encouraging.
What her results indicate to me is that her normal pituitary has been pretty well destroyed. Whether this was an effect of the tumor or the surgery or the radiotherapy is not clear, but certainly she's got very little normal pituitary function left at all.
Defen is no longer secreting the hormones necessary for her body to function properly, causing low blood pressure, thinning of bones, dizziness and fatigue, all increasing her risk of falling again. She faces a difficult future. But at last, Defen is amongst her family again. She is home.
I really missed home, but I would really like to have come back after I had fully recovered. I'm still worried. I've no idea whether I can be mobile again or if I can recover to how I was before the fall.
But there is hope for Defen. Professor Grossman has pulled strings and arranged a supply of drugs that will reverse the effects of her tumor and replace the hormones no longer produced by her pituitary.
We know that for Yao Defen's family, they're quite a poor rural family. Money really is quite an issue. So I've now got sponsorship so that we can help pay for her drugs, at least for the foreseeable future.
The drugs should help her sight, ease her mobility, and hopefully prevent a potentially fatal fall. For Defen, it's another chance to grasp life.
I want to be able to get out of bed and be able to eat meals and wash the dishes. Every day I would walk around, take a shower, and do things for myself. That would be perfect.